Yes, Ajay, how can I help you?
Sir, I am working as a cloud engineer. I have 7 years of experience. Previously, I work as a storage admin, and then I work as a Linux admin, and now I have shifted to the cloud admin from last 3 years
Awesome.
to AWS cloud. And my current package is including all PF that 18.6 LPA.
Good, good.
So, and here I have worked from home when I start this company from last year, 3 years. Also, I have flexibility morning and afternoon shift, so I can manage my personal work also. I have get most of the time to do any activity. So my fear is if I want to learn DevOps, this is my first thing. So my first question was, sir, which is best time to leave this company? I am comfortable here, but as per salary or
Comfortable has
technologicals.
like I would look at it in two ways, Ajay. Like comfortable because of this gives you flexibility of work from home, allows you to go to gym, allows you to do other things. If comfortable is that sense, then why not continue in this company? Why do you want to leave it? Like that's some of the advantages of working from remote, working from home are right. So if you are comfortable that your day-to-day work is similar and you are not learning new things and it's getting very BAU kind of work, you are not getting quality solution designing and you think that your learning has stopped, then you should look at options that, yes, should I leave it because this gives me comfort in other sense as well. So that then it's a, then you have to assess, you have to tell us which kind of comfortable feeling you have.
Okay, sir, so here my day to recently, because of in previous team I have don't have much work. There are S1 cases that when I get the call for S1 cases, I troubleshoot databases up, then check the logs, var log message, then check the on the AWS console there is a hardware issue, there's the ticket, there repetitive task, and after that there is a sync to install the package, to check the sync services, to check CloudWatch log. And now recently I have in now change of streams where to enable the feature to do some expansion of on the cloud. So basic tasks are now I'm getting, but that are related to the mostly the product related, not as a cloud or DevOps related.
Okay, those are
So
usually looking troubleshooting the product more than the cloud.
yes, cloud and DevOps related, I don't have that. So what do you suggest me, to stay here
It's
or
tricky
leave?
because that's not my expertise that I
Okay.
guide based on your situation. Like, should you do a remote job or in office job or in a city X or city Y? I would critically look at my learning opportunities. If this job provides you enough time to upskill yourself, now you can, while working in this job, if it gives you enough time and few other benefits, you can use that time to do your certifications, do your side projects if you want to. It could be freelancing
Okay.
projects, it could be practice projects for you, things that your company does not allow you, could be DevOps related projects. Could be cloud related
Okay.
complex projects. So it could be anything. So I would look at it that way. Once my learning stops, usually at 3 4 years experience in a company, I would look at if my learning has stopped, I'm not getting quality work. The work I'm getting is pretty similar to what I was doing few months ago. If you get into that kind of situation, then you start thinking that yes, I should be learning new things, and based on my new things, where I can apply, and you should be applying. And I would look at getting out of my comfort feeling and go to another company. You should get a good Wi-Fi if you are working from home full time.
Sir, my second question is like, sir, so like the today is like when I start my day and end my day, I heard AI, AI, AI. So I really confused like which technology I need to learn, which path I need to follow for the career. So
Are you comfortable with your cloud skills and that do you think there are some gaps?
For cloud, I'm like I have also I have done the certificate of AWS solution architect, self-study.
Professional?
So, no, not professional,
Okay.
associate. I'm
Do the
planning
professional
to
level as
like.
well. Do the professional level as well.
Okay.
And
Okay.
AI, yes, AI is coming and it's coming fast. We have to be ready. We just cannot sit in isolation and say that no, this will not impact my work. But the good thing is you are in the cloud space. Cloud people and the DevOps people, these are the first sort of people who will be easily able to understand some of the AI concepts. You will be able to utilize AI. Will be the first people to work on AI
Okay.
projects, real projects. So everything AI related somehow is related to cloud. So it's always the cloud folks will be deploying those models or utilizing those services. AI services are offered by GCP, Azure, AWS for a reason that these they can be very easily integrated into their model, their subscription. So not a bad position to be in. If you are good at cloud, you should upgrade yourself, get into AI.
Okay, so like sir, I need to follow now DevOps path
First DevOps,
to
be
any
com
certificate
no, no,
or
first focus on a bit of more on DevOps side because that's where the jobs are, that's where the
okay.
your experience is related, closely related. You just cannot say I am cloud expert if you don't know DevOps, because everything in cloud will be through DevOps processes.
Okay.
So you have to be comfortable in DevOps as well. Once you think that your DevOps and cloud skills are good enough and you think you should upgrade to AI as well, then that's the time you should start doing that.
Okay, sir. And sir, like if I do a course that pro, like after doing that and after practicing that, so I will get in the
Get a good router, man. Get a good bandwidth. I can't hear you. You will get good opportunities. You will eventually, at some stage, you will have to do AI. So